you guys. So I just watched Alex Carpenter's review of Les Mis, and it inspired me to make a Les Mis review. So this is my Les Mis review. It's good to clear everything up and say that I come from a musical background. I love musicals, and Les Mis is one of my favorites. The music is just beautiful, and what makes it so awesome is that the entire story is made up through the music, and it's very weak lines, if any, in the actual musical. The settings are bland. It's all through the music. And so, knowing that about Les Mis, it was interesting to see how they turned it into a movie musical. Now, if any of you guys didn't know, Les Mis was actually filmed live. So the soundtrack was not pre-recorded. They did not do playback and the singers, you know, lip sync or anything to it. They actually sung the music with earbuds in their ears with a piano part so that they could stay on tune and stay on track, and it was not anything pre-recorded. I think this method is very interesting, but it definitely took away from the music because the actors who were picked for the main parts were big names. We got Hugh Jackman, Russell Crowe, Amanda Seyfried, whatever her last name is. We have Anne Hathaway, like big names, well known as actors. And though each of them can sing, the acting was definitely more important. I really enjoyed the movie. I did. I cried. I laughed. I did all the things expected, and I really, really enjoyed the cinematography. One of my favorite details in the movie is that when there was a major solo, they would focus on the face. That's all they would do. They would focus on the face, the person, and the voice. They focused on the actor and their emotion and how they brought out the song. That, I thought, was an excellent quality of the film. It was the music that really did not make me happy, because that's what musical is about. I mean, it's about the music. One of my major plights with the movie was the chorus numbers. The chorus numbers in Les Mis are amazing. They're full, they're loud, they're emotional, and they're strong. There's something different about hearing a pre-recorded sound, and it makes it more full in the theater. It makes the surrounding sound just bigger and in your ears. And when it's live recorded like they did, it just sounded weaker. My favorite chorus number is At the End of the Day, which is the first major song in the movie. At the End of the Day's first few lines were sung, they weren't sung, and that was my big problem with the entire movie, was that so much of the movie was rhythmic speaking or just like half singing. And it's because they focused on the acting. For the actors and actresses, my favorite was Anne Hathaway. She blew me away. She is so good, and I knew she could sing because she sang in Ella Enchanted. She was one of the few of the entire movie, besides the Barricade Boys and their leader, who is, I know from like articles and things, he comes from the theater, and Eponine, who also comes from the theater. She played her in the 25th anniversary of Les Mis, which Nick Jonas was also in. He played Marius. But Anne Hathaway sang her part. She gave it emotion, but she also was concerned about the music. And she is just, her voice is so good. It is pure, it's simple, and it's not, it doesn't have too much like heaviness. It's just like, I could talk about how good her voice is all day, basically. My least favorite was Amanda, because her voice is so feathery, and though her voice does match the original soundtrack, the girl's voice of the original soundtrack, they have the same like lighter tone. When she sings up high, her vibrato is just like, it's like little bird wings. They're just, it's just not pretty, and it's so, like, screeching sound. It reminds me of the girl who played, Joanna in Sweeney Todd. Hated her voice, too. It's just, those are hard parts to sing. You can tell that these actresses aren't trained singers, because they don't sing with any support when they sing those high notes. It's just, like, breathy and just air and, I would prefer in a movie like this that they pick unknown people to play these parts. or pick people from the theater, from musical theater, from Broadway, to play these amazing parts, these classic parts, instead of these actors just because they're well known. I don't understand it, but you know, that's Hollywood. I did really enjoy the movie a lot. I really did. I don't want to like make it sound like I hated it because I thought the music was half-assed. If it wasn't a musical, I would have been like, A+, greatest movie ever, we'll see you again. But the music,